Hello everyone.
Today we'll discuss the topic hemodynamic and the electrophysiology of heart by Professor Sabashik. So first we'll see the location of the heart. So the heart is located in the mediastinum. So in this diagram, you can see here that this is the portion where the heart is present. Then the next is, what do you mean by hemodynamics? So hemodynamics refers to the movement or the flow of blood. Hemodynamics are also the dynamic to the flow of heart. So in a very simple term, hemodynamics is nothing but the study of the flow of blood in our body. Now let's see the systemic and the pulmonary circulation. So you can see here, what happens here, the right atrium consists of the deoxygenated blood. This deoxygenated blood, it comes from the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava and the coronary sinus. So these three pour the deoxygenated blood into the right atrium. The blood from the right atrium goes to the right ventricle through the tricuspid valve. And then from the right ventricle through the pulmonary valve, the blood goes to the pulmonary trunk and the pulmonary arteries. And from here, the blood goes to the lung for the purification. So in purification process, what happens here? In pulmonary capillary, the blood loses carbon dioxide and gain oxygen. Now, as the blood loses carbon dioxide and gain oxygen, so what happens? Now the blood is converted into the oxygenated form. So now this oxygenated blood through the pulmonary vein, it goes to the left atrium. Then from the left atrium, it goes to the left ventricle through the bicuspid valve. And then from the left ventricle, the blood through the aortic valve goes to the aorta and systemic arteries. And then from here, in systemic capillaries, what happens? This blood loses oxygen and gain carbon dioxide. So now the blood again become deoxygenated. So now again this deoxygenated blood goes to the right atrium and this cycle continues. So this is termed as a systemic and the pulmonary circulation. Now let's see the conduction system of heart. So conduction system of heart consists of 5 different components: SA node, AV node, AV bundle, bundle branches and Purkinje fiber. So in conduction system of heart, the impulse is generated at SA node. This impulse from the SA node is traveled to the AV node. At AV node, a 100 millisecond delay occurs, due to which it leads to the contraction of both the atria. Now, the impulse from the AV node goes to the AV bundle. From the AV bundle, the impulse then goes to the bundle branches and finally to the Purkinje fiber. And this leads to the contraction of the ventricle. So this is nothing but the conduction system of heart. Now next is the ECG. So what do you mean by ECG? So ECG is nothing but the electrocardiogram. So an electrocardiogram records the electrical signal from heart to check from different heart condition. So you can see here the normal ECG consists of P wave, QRS complex and T wave. So this P wave indicates the atrial depolarization. QRS complex indicate ventricular depolarization and this T wave indicate the relaxation. Now the next part is the cardiac action potential. So the cardiac muscle is a specialized tissue with a unique property like excitability, contractility and automaticity. So as we all aware of that, our myocardium consists of two different type of cell. One is the contracting cell and one is the conducting cell. So this contracting cell participate in pumping action of the heart, whereas this conducting cell have a characteristic property of automaticity. Now let's see the cardiac action potential. So cardiac action potential basically consists of four different type of phases. phase 0, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 and the phase 4. So initially the resting membrane potential is minus 90 millivolt. The meaning of minus 90 millivolt is that the resting membrane potential or the cardiac membrane is become more negative. Okay, so what happens when the proper stimulus come? Due to the stimulus, the sodium channel open. When the sodium channel open, the fast entry of sodium ion occur and this lead to the rapid depolarization. That's why in this graph you can see the rise in a very sharp rise occur. Okay, the membrane from minus 90, now the membrane become close to plus 10. Okay, then the phase 1, that is nothing but the rapid repolarization occur. In rapid repolarization, the efflux of potassium occur. So in here what happens, the potassium channel open and the small amount of potassium from the inside of the membrane goes to the outside. So due to which the small amount of deviation occur, small amount of, you can say the membrane is slightly the positivity of the membrane is slightly reduced. Then the phase 2 is the prolonged plateau phase and this is occurred due to the slow entry of calcium. Now in this particular phase what happens, the calcium channel now open, okay, and the slowly the calcium channel enter into the cell membrane, due to which the prolonged plateau phase is occur. Then in case of the phase 3, the rapid repolarization with the efflux of potassium occurs. So in case of the phase 3, what happens, the potassium channel now open for prolonged period of time. When the potassium channel is open for prolonged period of time, the maximum amount of potassium is move out of the membrane. So now due to the removal of excess potassium ion or due to the removal of positive ion from the membrane, now the membrane is start declining toward the negative side. And then finally in the phase 4, which is nothing but again a resting phase, the potassium return into the cell and the sodium and calcium move out of the cell. So as the sodium and calcium move out of the cell and potassium is also returned into the cell, so this lead to the membrane again come back to the resting state, that is nothing but the minus 90 millivolts. So this is nothing but the cardiac action potential. So if I want to summarize this, so cardiac action potential in phase 0, sodium channel open, due to the opening of sodium channel rapid depolarization occur. Then move to the phase 1, in phase 1 the rapid repolarization occur. Why? Because due to the efflux of potassium ion. Then in phase 2, the prolonged plateau occur due to the slow entry of calcium ion. Here the calcium ion open and this lead to the slow entry of calcium ion. Then phase 3 is the rapid repolarization and it is normally occur due to the efflux of the potassium. Whenever the potassium efflux from the membrane, the membrane always become negative. Then the phase 0 is nothing but the resting phase. Here the sodium and calcium move out of the cell and again the membrane become the resting state, that is nothing but the minus 90 millivolt. So this is about the cardiac action potential. Now next is the cardiac output. So cardiac output is the volume of blood ejected from the left or the right ventricle into the aorta or pulmonary trunk in each minute. And the stroke volume is nothing but the amount of blood pumped out of the ventricle in one beat. So in one beat, how much amount of blood is pumped out of the ventricle is nothing but the stroke volume. So if I want to calculate the cardiac output, so cardiac output is nothing but the cardiac output is equal to stroke volume into heart rate. So this is about our the introductory part of the hemodynamic and the electrophysiology of the heart. Thank you.